Good evening, Toastmasters.
Good evening.
My name is Dan.
Hi, Dan.
I'm gonna talk about fear with Dan. I'm not talking about some horror stuff, something you see on TV. I want to know what this is, what makes you piss in your pants. I'm talking about petrifying fear. For me, when I work in the United States, my job basically dictated my fear. In New York City, I was a cop for 15 years. I was also a soldier for 7 years, both together at the same time sometimes. As you can see, I look like a badass a little bit, right? In American culture, your job defines who you are. That also gives you an expectation, sometimes, especially in this profession, of arrogance, of knowing it all. But sometimes, and even being a New Yorker, New Yorkers think we know it all. It's just the way we are. But sometimes, that's when it stopped. And it did for me one day. This is the day that it happened. I was in visiting my parents at that day, and I had to rush to Manhattan for this. This is 9/11. Thousands of people died on that day. Civilians, not police, not firefighters, and not the workers, but civilians in those buildings, those towers, thousands of people. Among the first responders, that's police, soldiers, firefighters, EMS, tens of people died because they were there either trying to rescue the people, trying to get them out, or they were just helping out, trying to, the building came crashing down on them. This was very common. The entire street area that night, for the first few nights, was nothing but like black haze hanging over the city. You could actually smell the death. The steel was burning, the asbestos, the gasoline, you name it. Nobody was coming out of there alive. There was not one body. We only had a morgue. Nobody came out alive. So for me, this is the day that it stopped. Because when you know you're living the high life, so to speak, and all of a sudden this comes crashing down on you, like a fist, or you hit a hard wall, that's when it happened for me. Then as time developed and went on, I started having more tragedy in my family. And also, like, my mom died in 2002. That's not up there anymore. But that hit me hard because, you know, when you're close to your parents, when you lose somebody you really care about, that's going to sink you in, even more of a deep depression. Then things evened out over time period. Then these two officers got killed. I was working with them a few weeks ago before they got killed in 2007. A perpetrator or bad guy basically tried to rob a pizzeria. He saw them, he tracked them down, went behind the car, and shot them point blank range in the head, both of them. We had to load them up on the ambulance that day. I took them to a hospital called St. Vincent's. They were put down dead on the right wing. I saw myself in those officers because I did the same work that they did. When you actually had colleagues and co-workers who were killed in cold blood because some idiot thought he would get away with it, turns out that a couple blocks away he was shot by plain clothes officers dead because he decided to kill these officers. So that got me thinking a little bit, even more. After death of my mom, 9/11, these two officers, colleagues of mine, died. I had my head all screwed up because I put myself in their place. When you see yourself in the coffin in place of them, trust me, that arrogance stopped cold. Then, a couple of buddies of mine in my unit, they're in Kandahar province in Afghanistan. They got hit by an IED with their Humvee. They died instantly. It's called 155mm shell. Was planted out by the Taliban. They rolled over, boom, we died. When I heard about this, I tried it for like 3 nights straight. These two guys, I remember perfectly because they were in my unit. They were my brothers in arms. We drank together, we slept together, we trained together, we would bleed together. they died first. More friends of mine who died. This man here was one of my commanders. He died from cancer from 9/11. This brother of mine just took his life just this past year. Shot himself in the head with his own service bomb. So the pressure is that he was doing. He couldn't take it anymore. The pressures of the job basically dictate what you might and might not do. The question is, what fears do you have? My fear is dying alone. When you start looking at a horror movie, when you start thinking about being drawn in from the suspense that's happening, from the violence on the screen, then all of a sudden, you wake up saying, oh my God, it's not real. Tell me, what fears do you have? What makes you piss in your pants? That's my speech. I believe. Thank you.